Hello and welcome. Today we make a cable that will power an external hard drive and you can use it on your mobile phone and charge it at the same time. For this you can use an old USB cable. And first you just cut one end and the other end, also this part, keep it. And this side is mini USB and we can't use it for this because our project is for micro USB. So we cut that one and we keep it for something else later. So what we have now is one short male USB connector and a USB cable that has no connector at any of the ends. Prepare the both ends of the cable to solder them, so remove the insulation and prepare the cables. On the cable that has the male USB connector, we remove the white and green cables and cut them, just make sure they don't get shorted later on, so maybe not so as short as I did here. So we will only use two cables, the black and the red one, for power. Prepare the USB connector and cut the cable so they're the same length and shorter than before. And now this is how you wire them on the screen. Pin 1 is here and then it goes 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the diagram we will use. This is a normal diagram for OTG, but in our case we will use the power later, so we attach the power to black and red. The black and red here, they will have the external power. So I show you here, pin 1 goes there and that's one
positive plus pin 1, 3, 5. This is pin 2, 2 and 4.
Yeah, that was the story. So just wire them as you've seen in the diagram and it's not so difficult, just take your time, don't make it too fast.
Pins 1, 2, 3, 4. Red, white, green and black.
Also cut the wires so they're short and at the same length. And this is how you connect everything. So now the next step is to attach the male USB connector. This is where the external power comes in and it's just a matter of connecting the red to red and black to black. And this is how it's the easiest thing to do it, just merge them. Like this, it's a good connection and also you can protect it from mechanical stress later on. Be sure that there is no short between those white and green wires from the short male USB cable. And put a heat shrink on top of it and this one will really it will keep everything together. Between pin 4 and 5 you can put either a wire or a 100k resistor. I wanted to test both options and here I have a switch that enables me to switch between them. I'm starting with the switch disconnected, so it's on the 100k resistor. As soon as I plug it in, the tablet starts to charge but the USB doesn't work on this USB flash drive. The power bank charges it while the USB doesn't work. So I've read that this could be different depending on the device. So on my tablet this doesn't work with the 100k resistor, so you might want to make the cable with the switch so you can switch between modes. Look at what happens when I turn on the switch. That's like having a wire between pin 4 and 5 and it's just like a regular OTG cable. But on this tablet it doesn't charge. When I do that you will see it stops. After a while it just stops charging. So that's not good news, but on other devices it works. I will show you later. I wouldn't want to have a switch like that on the cable and for me the 100k resistor doesn't really do anything. So that was a good test, but I'm going to remove it, and I advise you don't even use a 100k resistor, just use a wire between pin 4 and 5, and that should do the trick, like this. You can use any wire, just as long as it's small enough so it doesn't interfere with the case. When you're ready, put hot glue around the USB connector, especially the one that where you join the cables together, just so that there is a mechanical protection from mechanical stress, so the wires don't break over time when you use the cable. Put as much as you like. There is no right or wrong, but I would say don't put too much, just put enough so you can cover it. Then just placing a heat shrink on top of both cables, and the magic of heat shrink cable does this. It looks pretty good. So that's the cable. We have one male USB connector on one side, female USB connector there, and the micro USB that goes into the phone or the tablet here. I just placed this red heatsink on that one also, because I couldn't really put the connector back on how it should have been, but it works, and that's the cable. So let's test it. You plug the hard drive on the female connector, and then the male connector will go into a power bank or a charger or anything that provides USB power. Here is a good demonstration of the USB rule that says you have to flip a USB connector 3 times before you get it right. Okay, now finally it's connected. As you see, the hard disk powers on a little, sees there is no data, because now it's only connected to power. And it powers off, it goes into standby. So now, after we connect the power bank, we connect the tablet, and look, the magic happens. The tablet can use this external hard drive, which would normally not work with this tablet or any other tablet or a mobile phone, because normally the tablet doesn't have enough power, it doesn't provide enough power for this hard drive to work. But now we are using it on the tablet, and we could even use it on a phone. That's pretty useful sometimes. The problem on this tablet is that while it can use the hard drive and the external device is powered, this tablet doesn't get charging. It's not charging while I use it like this. Other devices do, and I will show you that you can have another device working.
Thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos that actually work.
And this, let's see on the Xiaomi phone. The phone can access a flash card, a flash drive, and the phone is also charging at the same time. You can see while I'm browsing the card, it's charging. I couldn't make it work with the hard disk, and I think because of the phone I couldn't do it. So other phones, it's because of compatibility and file systems, and I didn't want to change the file system on the hard drive. But as you see, it's charging and using the USB at the same time. Now the USB is disconnected. I plug it back in, and it shows up there. It's ready to use, and it's charging. That's pretty good. So this is charging with just a wire without any resistors. Don't waste your time trying to put switches and resistors and all this. Just make sure you have a device that is compatible. It depends on the modes, the OTG modes, and which one is default. You could even change it through software if your device is rooted. You could change the setting so that the OTG behavior is how you want it. this is it. I hope you liked the video and I hope you want to see more like this. Let me know in the comments what you did, if you did this cable or if you have another device that you want to power it through USB. Like the video, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to this channel if you're not already subscribed, and hit the bell to get notifications when we upload the new videos. Tell your friends about this channel, share it wherever you can, subscribe, like and share, and I will see you next time. Bye.